press the bell icon to never miss an update from placement interviews.
Hi guys, this is Sunidhi from Placement Interviews, and today we have Naman who is here to share his GRE journey with us. Please reach out to us if you want to be interviewed, or if you know somebody who would like to be interviewed. You can reach out to us on our mail or comments or the social media handles. Till then, I hope you enjoy this video. Keep watching.
Hi, my name is Naman Maheshwari. I'm a fourth year computer science student at Netaji Subhash Institute of Technology. I wrote my GRE in the third year and my score was 331. I got a 168 in quant, a 163 in verbal, and a 5 in AWI. GRE is an exam that is divided into three sections. There's AWI, which is the writing skills, there's a quant section, and there's a verbal section. So AWI section is the writing skills section. The most important thing here is practice. Also, it is very important to understand the question. You should take some time to understand what the question is trying to say, and only then should you begin to write. Practice is also very important, because unless you develop a habit of writing, ideas and phrases won't come to you very easily. It's also important that you're grammatically sound and you use the correct spellings. Do not get carried away by your own emotions and your own beliefs. Sometimes you need to go against your beliefs to use points that are easier to come by. The quant section is the mathematics section. The curriculum here is pretty easy and it is taught to high school kids in India, so it is not a very difficult section. But it is important that you practice questions so that you're familiar with the formulae and the concepts, and you're able to recall and apply them very quickly. You should also be able to pick up some tips and tricks on how to solve certain types of questions, so that if those questions arise, you don't waste time on proper evaluation of the questions. The verbal section was the one that I found the most challenging. It mainly comprises of two parts. One is the vocabulary part, which involves text completion and sentence equivalence. The other part is the reading comprehension, where you're given a paragraph and then you're asked some questions which you have to give correct answers to. In the vocabulary part of verbal section especially, vocabulary is very important. You need to know the words, the exact meanings. Sometimes synonyms tend to have slightly different meanings, and they vary in the degree of nuances. The other thing is that sometimes we do not know some meanings of some particular words, and we tend to use only the meanings that we know. It is very important that you know each and every meaning of words to be able to correctly place them in their context. Text completion and sentence equivalence sections are vocabulary intensive, so it is very important that you know the meanings of words and you know how synonyms differ from each other in terms of their subtleties and in terms of their nuances. In these questions, you have to give the answers quickly, and there's generally not enough time for you to figure out the context, and also the sentences are small, so context is also limited. So it is important that you're thorough with your vocabulary and you're quickly able to pick up words. The reading comprehension section involves reading through a paragraph, understanding it, and then answering questions based on it. The biggest problem that I faced here was that I'm a fast reader and I tend to skip on details. I also tend to substitute my own meanings instead of trying to understand what the author is trying to convey. It is very important that you read carefully and you understand what the author is trying to convey instead of using your own interpretations to answer questions. After understanding what the author is trying to say, we were supposed to answer questions within a limited time frame. For answering questions, we were taught several techniques to quickly eliminate answer choices that were incorrect. After elimination, we were left with two or three answer choices that could be the answers. For eliminating further, we were taught how to find out subtle differences between these answer choices and then pick the answer choice that fit the bill perfectly. Lastly, I would like to wish a very best of luck to all those who want to take GRE. Do not take the exam lightly and do well, score high.
So that's it for for this video. I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Also click on the notification button to get all the notifications for our awesome sauce videos. Please reach out to us if you want to be interviewed or if you want us to visit your campus for the interviews. We'll make sure we do that. Drop a mail or a text message on all our social media handles and we'll try to get back to you ASAP. Till then, I hope you enjoy this video. Bye.